the country. The question which was asked to you was this. There's a person who has come to you, right? And the person has come to you with certain amount of information which he has with him. The first information which he has with him is that this particular ear, or the right ear, which is the better ear, or the non-test ear, has bone conduction thresholds of 0 dB HL across 250 Hz to 40 Hz. This much is clear. So, one information is that this particular ear, which is the right ear, has bone conduction thresholds of 0 dB HL from 250 Hz to 40 Hz. The second information which you got in is the left ear, which is the poorer ear, or the test ear, has mass threshold. The cochlea has responded for sounds at 80 dB HL. Okay? So this cochlea has responded, so it is mass threshold. So they have given you these thresholds. Now the question which is put up to you is, if you do AC thresholds of the left ear unmasked, what would be the curve that you would be getting? That may be a shadow curve, forget about it. But if you just place a TDH 49 headphone and find out the thresholds of the left ear, what would be the thresholds? And if you put an insert phone and then find out the AC thresholds of the left ear, what would be the threshold? That was the question put up, right? So the question is clear. The transducers which I use are TDH 49 headphones and ER3A insert phones. The BC threshold of the right ear is 0 dB HL between 250 Hz to 4 kHz. As given, the BC Mars threshold of the left ear is 80 dB HL from 250 Hz to 4 kHz. That's also given out there. And the question is, plot the unmasked AC thresholds of the test ear or the left ear or the poorer ear. In two conditions. The first condition is TDH 49 and second is ER3A phones. Correct? So if we plot out everything like this and then say this is the right cochlea and it has 0 dB HL thresholds. Clear? Clear? Right cochlea, 0 dB HL thresholds, 250 to 4 kHz. This is clear. Right? We have a TDH 49 headphone delivering out sounds to the left ear. Okay? So it starts delivering out sounds to the left ear. And these sounds go and hit the cochlea. This is clear? Clear, right? But beyond a particular intensity, the AC transducer starts behaving as a what? DC transducer. That means, beyond a particular intensity, the AC sounds coming from an AC transducer actually start vibrating the skull. So the AC transducer starts behaving like a DC transducer, clear? Beyond intensity, clear? Now, these have started coming from here to here, okay? Now, can somebody tell me, when do they just reach the opposite cochlea, that is the right cochlea? At what intensity? 40 dB. 40 dB, that is known as the IA. Remember that. So, the concept of IA is important. At 40 dB HL, the sounds have reached the other cochlea on an average, okay, for all the frequencies. So, at 40 dB HL, the amount of sound present at this cochlea is how much? 0 dB. How much? 0 dB HL. Is this clear? This is clear now. So it is 0 dB HL. Done. Now, if 0 dB HL sound is reaching out the right cochlea because of the vibrations created by the sounds delivered by TDH 49 headphones, to the left ear, will the right cochlea respond? Understood? It will respond, no? It will respond, right? Because we have already given 0 dB sounds to the right cochlea. So, if you are using a TDS 49 headphone and you are taking the hint to be the IA to be 40 decibels across all the frequencies, then the left ear threshold, which I plotted in blue and across, using a TDS 49 headphone would be clear cut how much? This would be the thresholds if you are using a TDS 49 headphone, because the IA is equal to how much? 40 dBHL. Done. This is clear. What do you call this threshold to be? You call this threshold to be a shadow threshold. So, this is not a true threshold. This is a shadow threshold. This is clear. So, the first part of the question is answered. If there is a supraoral headphone given, a TDS 49 headphone given, then we would be having a shadow threshold of the left ear, which can be plotted like this, technically. Now we have changed the headphones. We know, depending upon the area which is in contact with the ear, the vibrations are transmitted. In an insert phone, the area of contact increases, decreases? Decreases. So the vibrations transmitted would be increasing or decreasing? Vibrations transmitted would be increasing or decreasing? Increasing, decreasing? Decreasing, because contact area is less. So more amount of energy is required out. So the IA for an insert phone would be more or less? More by fundamental rule, correct? If we deeply insert it further, the occlusion effect, which leads to the pseudo increase in DC. If we deeply insert it, the occlusion effect, which leads to pseudo increase in wall conduction, also decreases. So two types of advantage. One is the sound transmission is reduced out. The second is the occlusion effect is also reduced out. So I am putting in an insert phone here. So this is an insert phone here. We'll understand this now. The insert phones, I start giving in a sound. So it reaches the cochlea, correct? Then after a particular intensity, does the insert earphone starts vibrating out the skull bones? Yes, no? Yes, no? Yes, clear, be clear with it. That means after a particular intensity, the insert phone would be acting like a DC vibrator. So, the insert phone starts sending in sounds by vibrating the skull. This is the insert phone. The intensity by which the sounds reach the opposite cochlea or the right cochlea in 250 Hz, 500 Hz and 1 kHz are how much? If the sound reaches out 75 dBHL in the insert phones here, the insert phones gain the capability to vibrate out the skull in the low frequencies. So, when the sound given here is 75 dBHL, when it is 75 dBHL, then what happens? The sound which reaches out here is how much? 0 dBHL. It is 0 dBHL. Now, from the findings which have been given to you, do you think 0 dBHL would be enough to stimulate this opposite cochlea? So, the thresholds or the shadow thresholds which would be available would be how much? For the left ear, we've got with blue, it would be 75 till 1 kilohertz, the thresholds would be 75 dBHL, because the insert phone has already begun to vibrate the skull and the sound has reached the opposite cochlea. The sound which has reached the opposite cochlea is 0 dBHL, And because 0 dBHL is the threshold of the right cochlea, the cochlea responds. Can we get a shadow threshold? Correct? So shadow threshold is obtained. But when you start doing it for the frequencies of 1 kHz and above, that is 2 kHz, frequencies of above 1 kHz, that is 2 kHz, 4 kHz, then the IA is how much? 50 decibels. That means when the sound of 50 decibels, let's say when it reaches the sound of 50 dBHL, the insert phone for 2 kHz and 4 kHz starts acting like a bone vibrator and transmits out sounds because it vibrates the skull. So the amount of sound which reaches this particular point at 50 dBHL sounds to the left ear through an insert phone would be how much? 0 dBHL. So will the cochlea respond? It will respond. So if the cochlea responds, then there will be a shadow threshold which will be obtained at 50 decibels for 2 kHz and 4 kHz. So the shadow curve for an insert phone would be for 2 kHz to get this, while the shadow threshold for a PDH49 would be this. Is this clear? This all depends upon the IA which is introduced. Based upon the IA, we have a crossover. Based upon the VC threshold, we have a cross clearing. Okay, so this is the core concept of masking. IA, crossover, cross clearing, two different types of transducers, that's the TDH49 and insert phone, and frequency specific IA, especially in the insert phones where the low frequencies have a higher IA of 75, high frequencies a lower IA of 50 decibels. This much is understood? Right. So, thank you.